Welcome to the second episode of Programming with Qt Widgets. I'm Jesper Pedersen, and I'll be your trainer throughout this whole series. In today's episode, we will learn how to compile the application just created in the previous episode. I know what you're thinking now. Jesper, it's 2023, or possibly you're thinking of date after, or date before. And I know how to compile my applications. And really, I don't even need to know that anymore because I'm using an IDE and the IDE will take care of everything for me. And you are right to a large extent, but there are some traps here and there. And understanding what goes on underneath your level of IDE is definitely useful for those situations where things do not behave as you expect. It can be rather challenging to stay on top of all the different information flows that comes in. From KDAB, we made it easy. We put out a newsletter every month, and in that newsletter, you'll find information about the most recent YouTube videos we recorded and released, the most recent blog posts that we've written, important events that we might be going to, and software announcement overall. There's a link on the screen right now or in the section below. So you have two options, the red pill or the blue pill. Well, almost. We have one option, which is QMake. That's a tool that shipped with Qt and which was the de facto tool for being a meta compiler throughout 2 decades at least. And then the other options, which is a much more modern, namely CMake, which is the one you should be using, at least if you plan on anything bigger than Hello World. Let's look at what QMake looks like. And the reason why I'm talking about QMake in this series here is that all our examples use QMake. It's way easier to get started with QMake than it is with CMake. And after all, this is not about a compiler tooling series. If you want to learn about CMake, there is lots of resources out there, and I'll link to a few of those in the show notes below. In QMake, you specify which files you have and how these files should make it up a project. So what you see here is the helloworld.pro file. It's a complete QMake file for this project. It says my sources is main.cpp. I want to use widgets. And, well, I don't even have any header files. And then when you run QMake, what you get out of that, because QMake is a tool that's shipped with Qt, what you get out of that is a make file. It's a ninja file. Well, I don't think it's a ninja file, actually. That's only with CMake. It's a inmake file. It is whatever Xcode wants. It's what Visual Studio would like to have a project file there. And that will set up your compiler, will set up the path to where the global includes this, and so on. So using this file here, super easy to get started. QMake has lots of facilities, and there is a documentation available as a link below and right up here now that shows you all of what QMake can do. And I'm not going to go into details with that. As I said, it's just a tool that we'll be using throughout this training. QMake, as I said, will generate you a native make file in whatever format. And as I said, the way you run it is just run QMake on your profile, run your build system, whatever it really is, and then run your application. And of course, that's not what you want to do in real life. What you want to do in real life is you go to your IDE, and in your IDE, you have set things up already. Whenever you load in a file from this training, you will find that there is a profile here, and let's actually try and load in. So Control O for open, and there I'll find the profile. And now, well, it says project already open. So let's just close that project and open the project here again. Hello world. And now I have loaded in the project with all the files that goes with it. As my slide over here said, if you do not have a profile already and you want to get a profile, you can simply run qmake minus project. So let's go to a shell here and just look at what we have here. We have a few files. We have the hello world.pro. We have xhelloworld.pro.user, which I didn't mean to remove. Oh, well, that is just Qt Creator storing some information in there. Anyway, I wanted to remove this one, so we now have absolutely nothing. And I'll run QMake minus projects. And what you'll see is that I now got myself an xhelloworld.profile again. It looks slightly different from the one that I had written by hand, but hey, that's okay. The alternative, and the one you should be using, because QMake is very well connected with Qt. It was written together with Qt, and is a tool that was brought up together with Qt. So it served that purpose very well. But if you are developing larger applications and you need lots of dependencies found on your system, so if I have that specific charting library, load that in. If not, then set this flag. Look for that plot library that should be using this or that library if available. And if it's this version number, then and you know that's what real projects look like, at least those that I have been involved with. And for that, you really want to use CMake instead. And there is a tool on GitHub. We have a toolbox in KDAB that is called KD Tools, and there's a link here. And in KD Tools, there is a small binary, small script even called CMake minus project. And if you run CMake minus project, you will get a CMake list.txt file, and it looks like this. Not much going on. There is a few things in here that we'll talk about in future episodes. This is about running mock, and that is involved in the signal slot. But that is a very easy way of getting started. You can see this one here is about Qt 5, and I haven't even talked about that. But Qt 5, Qt 6, this training here will work for both of them. If there is a difference anywhere along the lines, I'll point it out to you. So if I want it to be Qt 6, then my CMake minus project fortunately has facility for doing that. I can specify minus Qt 5, minus Qt 6, 5 and 6 or none. And if I just run it here using this one here, 5 and 6, what you'll see, it doesn't like whenever there's a, that's nice of it. So when I run it like this, what you'll see now is a, not that one. That was a wrong. I was a bit surprised to see that output. Here is the CMake list.txt file. And what you'll see now is that it'll go and find a package for Qt 6 or Qt 5, and it needs to have these components in, and it links against Qt version major colon colon, Qt version major colon colon GUI, and so on. So that's your options, QMake or CMake. QMake is what we use in this training. CMake is what you really should be using in your own projects. And that's it for this episode here. In the next episode, I'll talk about how you navigate through the help system inside Qt. Until then, have a great time.